In this video, we explain you what is IEC 61131 and what the benefits are in using this standard. Let's start from the history. Before this IEC standard came up, many different programming languages had been used to program PLCs. To make the program code easier understandable for PLC programmers, the idea came up to unify these different programming languages into one international accepted programming language. This led in the year 1996 to the Open International Standard IEC 61131 for Programmable Logical Controllers, also called PLC. Currently, the third edition of this IEC standard is valid, which was published in 2013. Generally, the IEC standard covers 10 parts, as we see it on the slide, but we want to concentrate only on part 3, as it is the most important part for PLC programmers. Part 3 of the IEC standard is dealing with the basic software architecture of a PLC and the possible programming languages of a PLC. If you are more interested in the content of part 3, you will find more on www.plcopen.org. So let's focus more deeply into part 3 of IEC 61131 to explain what is understood under basic software architecture. First, common agreement is that the program code must be written in English syntax language, as English is most understood in the world. Second, the available data types with their according value ranges are also clearly defined. Third, the variable types, for example, what is a global variable type, what is a local variable type, and so on, is clearly defined. Fourth, these variable types can be assigned to different variable classes, for example, to var type or var global type. Fifth, how the PLC is configured by using tasks and programs is defined as well. Sixth, finally, the term programming organization unit is defined. These definitions are used as a common basis to create a PLC program. Under ideal circumstances, this program code can be used in any other PLC that follows the IEC standard. Part 3 of the IEC standard also defines 5 different programming languages from which the user can select from. On the upper left of the slide, the instruction list is shown. It is a textual language, which is, however, already deprecated in the third edition of the IEC standard, so it is not recommended to use it anymore. On the lower left of the slide, the function block diagram is shown, which is a graphical language. Next to the function block diagram, the ladder diagram is shown, which is a graphical language as well and widely used. The fourth language is called structured text, a textual language which is mainly used to program complex algorithms in an efficient way. Programmers who are familiar with C language will be able to quickly understand this language. The fifth language is the sequential function chart, a graphical language which can be used to visualize final state machines. Many PLC manufacturers offer within their programming software already predefined functions and function blocks which fulfill the programming guidelines according to IEC standard. This guarantees an easy and efficient way of programming. Instead of using proprietary functions as it is displayed on the left side of the slide, a standardized and also more flexible IEC function can be used. So, let's summarize the main advantages when PLC manufacturers support the programming guidelines of the IEC standard in their software. First, the IEC standard is widely used and well known. Second, it simplifies the understanding of existing program code. Third, a time-saving and more efficient programming is possible. Fourth, reusage of already written program code is possible for third-party PLCs. And fifth, PLC programmers can choose from 5 different programming languages and can choose their preferred language. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching and feel free to check out the other videos on our website.
Panasonic.